we doing, everybody? Welcome to Three Blogs with Beards. I'm Zach, and today I am very excited to play Mafia 3. Very little known about this game. I haven't looked that much into it, but I did play the other two, loved them. Wanted to surprise myself with the third one, played it a bit, liking it so far. Enough said, let's play. Except for that. New game, yes, new game. Okay, so I'm just going to keep it on easy with a high aim assist, because if you've watched any of my other videos, you know how much I suck at games. Alright. Another loading screen. Another loading screen. The same loading screen. The same loading screen again. Same loading screen for the third time. Ooh, new loading screen. It loaded! Mafia 3 takes place in a fictionalized version of American South in 1968. We sought to create an authentic and immersive experience that captures this very turbulent time and place, including depictions of racism. We find the racist beliefs, language, behaviors, some characters in the game abhorrent, but believe it's vital to include these descriptions in order to tell Lincoln Clay's story. Most importantly, we felt that not to include this very real shameful part of our past would be an offensive to the millions who faced and still face bigotry, discrimination, prejudice, and racism in all its forms. Hangar 13. Or, in short, trigger warning. To those of you who are too stupid to realize that in 1968 people were dicks. A more simple time. Although I did like the style of this time. It's very unique, and I do really like it. Underestimated how far he was going to go. Ooh. What he was willing to do. Hello there. Visit the historic French ward and enjoy local
cuisine at one of our five-star restaurants. Killing them wasn't enough. Lincoln Clay was using them to send a message.
Yes, he was.
What was the message?
In case you haven't figured it out by now, I'm just going to say it, put some context in for this movie. Right now, we're watching a questioning, I'm guessing, of certain people who knew the main character called Lincoln Clay. Mardi Gras, yay! This city survived the war. Oh dear. The Civil War, and God knows how many. Bloody hell, if I did all that, I am one destructive bastard. There he is, the man of the hour, Lincoln Clay. And Mafia 3.
Lincoln's mother abandoned him.
Or is this, I think this might be a documentary.
A couple of years after he was born. His mother, I heard she was Dominican. I always figured his father was white. Maybe even Italian. Not that it mattered. Back then, if you look black, you black.
If it didn't matter, why'd you bring it up?
Came as today, I suppose. He stayed at the orphanage until...
I'm just going to turn my telly up a bit. Give me 1 second. Where's my... Here it is. Looking for the zapper.
Lincoln Clay, 1966. I was running black ops out of Laos on behalf of the CIA. He was loaned out to me via joint CIA-DOD task force.
Backstory galore.
Good boy.
I will give him that. He does seem like a good guy, this character. Even if he is a bit... Oh, look at that with a beard. He looked good with a beard. Honor and
distinction. After the city closed the orphanage, he fell in with Sammy Robinson. Sammy ran the black mob over in Delray Hollow. I can't say I approve. But often colored boys didn't have a lot of options back then.
Boys are such a terrible time.
Ones who've been abandoned. They're always looking for home.
The smoke looks good. Always looking for the expressions are good and convincing as well.
I think he thought he'd find it in the army.
Ding!
Yes. Once that's lost, never get it back again. When he returned from the war, Lincoln ended back up over at Sammy's. Now Sammy owed the Italian mob a whole lot of money, and he needed Lincoln's help.
Of course, he doesn't need my main help. I'm the main character.
What happened? It breaks my heart.
Well, I'm dying at the end of this story. And now we're in Bug. With an armored car. Here I am, man of the hour. Just getting rid of this flat coke, we don't need it anymore. Using real money to rob the feds. Well, hell man, not like this is our cash. This all came from Skeletta. Besides, peanuts compared to what we're gonna haul out of there. Is everything we need to burn? Yeah, that's it. I grab the keys to the truck, then we can get the fuck out of here. Alright, I shall do so. I am curious as to why I set the sink on fire. She's in another room. Ironic as well that it's a sink that caught fire. Anyway, I'm off to go get the keys. La da la da la da la da la. And hello. I'm not sure about leaving him like this. He came through with the truck just like we asked. He even greased some part on to make it look good. If you got doubts, why take a chance? I don't know. I mean, last time I killed him, can I just walk away? Maybe these affections will affect... No, maybe these options will affect the game later. I don't know. Should I kill him? No, this time, just see if it's any different. I won't kill him. But he might turn to me and say, no, kill him. Anyway, I'm off to go into the armored truck. I got your keys. We should get going. Feel free to make yourself at home. Come on, There's a fire going if you want to roast something. Excuse me. I am talking, you do not interrupt. Fine, fuck you. If you're going to be rude, just, make yourself at home. I won't tell you what's here. Fuck you, get out of the way. Thank you. Alright. I'm a big man. Can open the door. Alright, let's move. Sorry, said that wrong. Right, into the Pinkerton Titan. Nothing compared to the Rockstar's Titan, but it's still a Titan of sorts. Alright, let's go! And... Oh, I like the bumpers at the back here. Those are cool. We don't need the cops crawling up our asses. Nope. But then again, we might get stopped because I'm a black man. He ain't got no idea what he's in for. What was his gun? 5%? They're about, not like he'll be able to spend it. Feds will be watching his every move for the rest of his life.
Probably be better we just whacked him. If I learned anything in Nam, always a good idea to dangle someone out there. Use them to get everybody's attention, and you just slip away.
That's dark, and that's cruel, but effective.
You don't want to know.
Hell man, I'm a taxpayer. I got the right to know how my money's being spent.
Out of the way! Sorry, I'm just trying to keep quiet so that you can listen to the story as well. I ain't going to prison for no fucking tax bill.
Huh. Are you going to answer the question or what? We're on the coast of Quang Nai. Evacuating the civvies for Charlie overran everything. Anyway, we getting them onto a medical ship. And this woman walks up. She got a baby in one hand and the leash to a pig in the other. She starts up the ramp. And the MP stops her, tells her, you can only bring one thing on board. So she tosses the baby into the water.
Good God.
He goes ape. Tells someone dive in after the kid, starts screaming at the woman, wants to know what the fuck she's thinking. You know what she says to him? She says, I can always have another baby.
Sorry, lady. I was distracted by the story.
Hey, man, you asked.
Yeah, but I thought you were going to tell me a story about some gook getting his dick blown off or something. I mean, God damn.
It's not a fault, but not like you think. The conditions over there, man. Jesus Christ. One day you're raising cattle, tending your rice. Next day everything bombed flat. You put people up against the wall, they will do anything to survive.
I can't help but think that the story has lost its dramatic tone because I missed the turning, hit somebody, and knocked over a fire hydrant. But yeah, there's gonna be some fucked up shit in this game. I think I can tell you that safely. We've already had a story about someone throwing a baby in the water. And yes, there was a difference when they were talking about that guy then, what's his cut, 5%? That's because I didn't kill him. Last time they didn't say anything about him. Or if they did, I wasn't paying attention. Anyway, we're almost there now. Just gotta keep driving through the bright lights in the big city. Excuse me, coming through, I have a 40, I'm in an armored truck, I'd run you over and destroy you instantly. Out of my way, ass whores. I see, that guy heard me. Thank you! And... break!
Goddamn,
That might have scratched the paint.
I think I may have hit two people that time. I think I've done more than scratch the paint. Let's have a look. Yep, I got blood on there. Well, if anyone asks, the truck's not finished. It was red, it was a post van, now it's not. Alright, here we go. Part two of the heist. So I'm just going to explain this quickly. This part I'm playing now is pretty much a prologue. So in this episode, however long it takes, I'm going to get this prologue done. And then cut it and see you in the next part. Either way.
Back it up to the loading dock.
Thank you. Non-generic security guard. Thank you. Where'd the bloodstain go?
Some of these fellas might get a little rough with the language and...
Well, ain't like I never been called nigger before.
Nah, I know, but I'm just saying, if I go along with it, ain't nothing personal.
I understand, Georgie.
The only thing I care about is getting our hands on that money.
Me too. Alright, let's get out and nick some money. Wash some money? Make some money? I don't know. There is a part coming up, though, I like simply because of... Well, actually, you know what? I'm not going to spoil anything. Right. Hello?
All
right. Hello? I'll have a number two, number five. Oh, yeah. You go first, then.
Put your IDs up the glass.
We're part of the Boeing crew.
What about me? I've got an ID to show. You what? Would you just call me? I mean, look at the size of this guy. Would you really be saying those sorts of things to his face? Fine, I'll go and get the bags, you asshole. Blah, 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 blah. Alright, first, I'll grab this one. And this one. Don't worry about the rest. I'll come back for it later. Any of you guys want to help? You know? Be nice for once. See that guy? That guy's trying to invent the iPad. He's busy.
Check that scatter gun. You packing anything?
Still in training.
Good. One less goddamn thing for me to worry about.
Shut your goddamn mouth. Excuse me, I shall lead the way.
Down in the cellar. This way.
I'm coming. Ooh, break room. Can I have a break? I'd love a coffee. Or anything else? How about a root beer? Yo, anyone got a root beer? Hello? Yeah, there's a good time going on in here, isn't there? Hey guys, how's it going? Just got some money? What are you looking at? Nothing. What's this? Flow House? I don't know if that's a real magazine or not. Let's have a look. Yeah. Shake it, baby. Don't feel awkward at all that three guys, including me... Now, four guys, including me, carrying loads of money is watching you. Your moves are a bit stale, though. I am not sexually aroused in any way. Goodbye. Hey, guys, can I have a beer? Guys? Yo. Hey! I have money. I can pay for it. Look at the money. Look at the money. I have money. Alright, guys. You know what? Fuck you. Fuck you. And especially fuck you. And fuck you too, water cooler. I don't know what you've done. You just... did summit and you made me mad. Alright, I'm off. Alright, which way do I go? I'm lost. Hello? Mr. Guard of Security? Excuse me, madam. Have you seen an asshole anywhere? Oh, I'm surrounded by assholes, honey. Yeah, what fucking hell you were. Bye. The noise I make when going down the stairs. Hello? Sorry, I was trying to enjoy myself a beer, but you guards are all assholes. Right, can I go in now, please? Thank you. Excuse me, coming through. Watch your step. Big man coming through. Moneymaker coming through.
Fuck you!
Christ, look at that. Didn't know y'all held that much gold.
That's a hell of a lot of gold.
Shuffling around on account of the war. It's here, and it gets sent to Dallas, and it comes back. It doesn't make a lick of goddamn sense. Here we are.
Okay, I might have accidentally skipped out the conversation here, but basically in that conversation, that arsehole security guard insults me for the last time. So I'm going to put these bags down and I'm going to show you what I do to absolute racist fuckwits. So first off, I will put this one down. And I will put that one down. Oh, good shot. Let me have a go. I want to go.
Fuck. That's some heat right there.
Used to use coal for it, but a year or so back we switched over to oil. Maintains a more consistent flame.
Here's some guy come around the house trying to switch me over to oil. Told him I wasn't interested.
Yeah. I grow bored of this story. Eat shit, motherfucker! Oh, I didn't do it! Last time I banged his head on that and smashed his head in there. Like, forced his head in this gap here and just kept slamming the lid down. He set on fire. That was a much better kill. Oh, well. Anyway, it's time for my favorite part of gaming. Stealth. I am stealthing. I am stealthing into the darkness. I am stealthing past money. I am stealthing up to this block of money. I am taking cover stealthily against this block of money. The game has frozen. Oh, right. Sorry, my bad. The game froze because it was telling me the prompt. Anyway, I am sneakily hiding against this money. I am waiting for these guys to shut up. I am going to grab this guy. I'm going to hide him behind this money. Who's talking? This boy's history. Last time I did that stealth killing them both, I just got a little carried away that time. But he dropped my favorite gun. The Tommy gun. It's a nasty scar on my head there. Right, you. Lincoln, get over here, man. He's dead. Yeah, he's fine. Do you like my new walk? I call it the Groucho. Right, let me in.
Oh, I hope this domination skeletor got us.
Legit.
I don't know. Is this music a little bit too electric? I don't know. Sometimes the characters look like they've got metal teeth at some certain angles. Go on, big man. Get that door. Spin it like a pro.
Yeah, human strength.
Go on, old Elvis. Yeah, holy fucking shit is right. This is like that scene from Jumper, except, you know, legit robbery. Not just teleporting in. It involves planning and stealing and being careful. For the most part, being careful. You stupid fuck!
Shit, I didn't notice this cage was on a different system. Alright, we're gonna hold off the guards. So Danny's done drilling.
Hey, we're gonna pull this off.
Damn straight, we're gonna pull this off. Right, give me a gun. I'm ready to kill. Gun, please. Oh yeah, I have a pistol. Oh no, there's a shotgun here. Well, I used the shotgun last time. Give me the Tommy. Oh yes. Right, here we go. I'll take the other side. Y'all ready for this? Bang, 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 bang. Wow, accuracy. Terrible. Surely one of those is gonna hit your head, or at least your hat. Nope. Alright then, fine. I'll save my last 5 bullets for when you come out. There we go. Oh, out of ammo. My bad. Butcha. Oh, there's some more. Bang. Oh no. I'm completely out of ammo. The rest is up to you. No, wait. I have a shotgun. I can try and get in close. Give me the shotgun. Thank you. Alright, here we go. Oh, fuck. Babooey! Babooey! Nope. He's taking ages to die. Thank you. I'm sorry about the shot in your nuts. Ooh! Oh! I think that one was genuinely his nuts. Hey, what's going on? Who's that? Is that another guy? Where are you? Oh, you're there. Wait, did that work? Did I actually shoot him through the cover? No, I'm blasting it away, though. Yeah. Go down, cocksucker. Oh, wait, hang on. Will I be able to... Hang on, I might see if I can get a melee kill on this guy. Hey! Oh, you bastard! You stole me kill, you bastard! Georgie, you fuck. Alright, let's have a look. What's this? I think it's another shotgun. I don't know what the stats are about. You see there, over the shotgun symbol. I don't know what that means. Am I picking up two bullets there or what? I don't know. Anyway, I'll stick with the riot. Keep the pistol.
Only way we walk out of here is if we get the weapon stored in that armory. Bust the door open. I'll watch our asses.
Yes, because an armory next to the safe is always a good idea. You need to keep them separate but close by.
Give me that damn thing.
Give me that damn thing, you stupid prick. I do like how he's like, give me that damn thing. But he's like, no, go on. Just get out of the way. I got this. Don't worry, man. Don't worry. You worry, pretty little hair, man. All right, here we go. So the way this lock picking works is you have to find the lock by moving your stick till it's green, like that. Then you have to stop the marker in the green and voila. High security gate opens by a low security crowbar. So I'm going to grab this thing. Hello, gorgeous. What's your name? His name was Hartman. That's a pretty name for a gun.
Look, Lincoln light gun. Lincoln shotgun. Lincoln go kill bastards.
Oh yeah, now here's the thing that annoys me, right? Here I am. Okay, right, they're throwing smoke. I'm ready to fire. I got a big gun. I'm ready to take out these motherfuckers as they come. Bring it on, you sons of bitches. Bring it on! Bah! And that's it.
Sammy had men all over the place. And one of them worked at a cleaner's and stole the uniforms Georgie Marcano and Lincoln Clay wore on the day of the robbery.
He did?
Another one was a janitor at the Federal Reserve, and he provided a rough layout. The robbery of the Federal Reserve was timed perfectly, and none of it would have been possible without the involvement of Sammy Robinson, Lincoln Clay, and the rest of the black mob.
Yay! I was important! Okay, one week before Mardi Gras. What happened 1 week before Mardi Gras? I got home. Yeah, I come home from the war. Having a good old smoke and chill.
Oh, you just come from Vietnam?
Wait for it.
I was a Marine in the Pacific. You take it from me. Just because you're home doesn't mean you're back. You understand? People around here, they don't get it. Never will.
Just two big guys talking.
Keep your ass out of trouble.
Oh, that's not gonna work. You know I will keep it. You know I'm gonna get in trouble. Well, at least that guy was nice to me.
Crossing the bridge.
And getting beer by the looks of things.
Excuse me, sir. I'm looking for my stepbrother, Lincoln Clay. You seen him? He used to get ticked off if you were even a minute late.
Kiss my ass.
There we go. There I am, pissed off.
How was the trip?
Lee, is how this is the first time in 4 years and somebody telling me where to go, what to do, or how to do it? It was fucking great.
Sweet. I have power now.
What's new with the old man?
Man, don't even get me started on Pops. He used to pull his head out of his ass.
Same as ever.
That's then. My brother there.
You have no fucking idea.
Damn, Ellis. She's looking good. Just like I left her.
Man, even I know not to fuck around with your cop.
Wow, I have baby from Supernatural.
Right, I'm ready to go home.
Well, he must have threw that bottle far. I didn't hear it smash. Anyway, I'm driving while intoxicated. I'm immediately getting into trouble. Alright, so, open the map. Click on the dog tag over here. And let's drive! Let's drive? Yeah, thank you.
Sammy's doing alright.
Ever since we got your telegram about coming home, he's been climbing the walls. What if the plane crashes? What if the train's delayed?
Oh, this is one of those games where I can beep the horn without moving my hands, look. Amazing. Right, fuck it. Fuck the law. I'm gonna get into more trouble. I'm already driving while intoxicated. Once in, all in, I guess. Whoa, fuck. Out of the way. Hey, oh, she had a burger. Give me the burger. Fine, fuck you. And now awkward silence while me and my brother, who I haven't seen for 4 years, Whoa. Just drive. Well, I drive this car erratically while he sits and watches as if this is the norm. Uh-oh. Look at the map. That blue square? It's the Popo. Fuck you, pigs. Fuck you, pigs. Just gotta behave. I'm not intoxicated. I swear. Intoxicated, I am not. Fuck the law code. I can drive better than you can anyway, cops, probably. Excuse me.
Can't imagine Sammy was too keen on that.
I think the graphics could be a little bit better, but this game does look pretty pretty. Did I just really say that? Pretty pretty? Ugh. The game does look nice. That's what I'm trying to get at. Cars handle well, yep. Whoop. Yeah, steady now. I'm not sure about the rocking of the camera, though, whenever I do a big turn. That could put me off. One thing I do like about this game, an old feature. Right there at the top of the screen. The wing mirror! Sorry, I got distracted by my wing mirror. Sorry about your car. I'm... see ya, bye! Fuck! Sorry, I'm traumatized from Nam. It's just, you know, cars getting in my way. Kind of. I think there was a policeman right there as well and nothing happened. By the way, how's my car looking? Oh, she's hurting. Don't worry, you'll regenerate as these games allow you to. Excuse me, coming through, thank you. Ooh, the bridge you got stuck on. I may have been speeding, but that cop didn't care. Works for me. I'm sorry, Arse. What were you saying? I was not listening. Because I was enjoying the game too much. Stop! Wait a minute. Fill my cup. Put some liquor in it. Safe. And excellent parking. Alright, let's go. Come on. Fine. I will go through the door like a war hero. Hey, everybody.
Boy, I send you to bring Lincoln Clearhorn.
Lincoln Clearhorn.
Well, shit, old man. I finally went somewhere they knew how to cook.
Welcome home, son. How are you?
I'll be better once I get some of that shine in me.
That shine in me. I do like the facial expressions in this. I don't think they've gone as far as to use the L.A. noir stuff, but even so, the facial expressions are good in this game, and I do like it.
He was joining the military. I was against it. Too dangerous, I say.
I'm the biggest guy here.
But then I realized Lincoln needed to go out and make his mark.
And made my mark, I did.
I'm so proud of you.
Don't start crying, Dad. You'll make me cry. Bienvenue à la maison, whatever it was. I like the skull snake. Oh, you're right there? You've been sniffing Joker gas? It's a big smile you got on yourself there. It's hard, I don't think you need a reason to be shit-faced.
Coming home from war. Elation. Fear. Guilt.
Boy.
Imagine being trapped in a dark room.
Okay.
And there's no way out.
Okay.
And every fear, every nightmare you ever had is in that room with you.
Sounds horrible.
And there's no escape from any of it. And then one day a door opens and you're free to go.
Oh, look at him go.
Your peace with your terror and your death.
Dirty old lady.
And now
treat you bad. But what choice do you have?
I've been drunk for 4 years. Give me a break.
Has to walk through that door, one way or another.
Man, whiskey's going hoit in the morning.
Hoit in the morning.
Sleep it off. The room's the same as he left it.
I'm gonna take the basement.
Why?
The basement? Why the fuck you wanna crash down there?
I'll see you in the morning.
Man, that wall must have really fucked you up.
But I'm still owed an answer. Why don't you want to go to your room? I want to see my room. I have a kitchen. Nice, nice. There's the bar. Nice, nice. End of a hallway. Nice, nice. Right, I'm going upstairs. I want to see my room. Maybe that will hold the answers to why I didn't go to my bed. There's only one room up here. The fuck? Do I not have a bedroom? Maybe that's why I'm sleeping in the basement. Oh well. Down the basement I go. I'm a little bit tipsy, although you wouldn't be able to tell because I'm still walking perfectly straight. Well, this guy can really handle his alcohol for probably not being able to drink it for 4 years in Vietnam. Right then, off to bed. Ooh, hello! Oh yeah, collectibles in this game, the magazines. And Playboy magazine is one of them. I do like that cover though, it's a nice cover. It would be interesting to see a Playboy from the 1960s, just to see how different they are from today. Anyway, I'm jumping into bed. Good night, y'all! Meanwhile, a sad priest looks on, wondering if the morning will come. And it did, but he's still not satisfied. Meanwhile, the infinity symbol on the cross next to him and the neon lights he installed constantly flash, and he cannot turn them off. Oh, where did I piss the bed? No, I'm good. Alright. Go talk to Sammy and Ellis. Ooh, a safe. Anything in the safe? No, can't crack this one open, despite the fact I pulled open a giant one earlier. Is it collectible? No, I thought it was collectible. Anyway. And before you ask, no. As far as I know, this is as fast as I can move indoors, unless there's something going on. Alright, into the kitchen. I want my steak and eggs.
We barely have two nickels to rub together, now we're paying for all that food. Jesus Christ.
Watch that mouth of yours.
We wouldn't be in this mess if you would have listened to me.
What mess?
Not something you need to worry about, Lincoln. I got it under control. Under
famous control. Last words.
God damn it, you need
boy, I'm not warning you again.
Have it your way, old man.
He's giving the people's eyebrow then.
He needs to cool off.
You mind telling me what's got him so riled up?
We've been having problems with the Haitians.
Like how'd you say that? Haitians.
Got it under control.
Okay, yeah, famous last words again.
I figured we got enough out there for. Should I come back?
In honor of your returning to us safe and sound. I made a donation.
You can't pull one on me. I know you're hiding something, old man.
Food he can hand out to some of our needier family.
I was hoping you'd lend me a hand, Lincoln, and give you a chance to see the neighborhood.
This thing with the Haitians, how serious is it?
Ah, you know Ellis. Someone looks at him the wrong way, he's on them like a wet dog.
Never heard that saying before.
I'll come back.
Nonsense. Lincoln needs to get out. Enjoy the day. Besides, be good for the two of you to spend some time together.
Yes, it would. Father, I've not seen for years and could be awkward. Some of the shit I've seen, man.
Oh, I saw Langan a couple times once he was first back. He told me he wanted to...
Wow, all the way to 2002.
Out to California. Now, he had a friend in the service who could get him a job working at the Mare Island shipyard. And the only reason he came back was to tell Sammy and Ellis goodbye. Then he found out about the trouble Sammy was having with those Haitians. So he decided to stay and help. Those Haitians, they are bad news. No talking Lincoln out of it. Whatever else he might have become, Lincoln was always loyal.
Damn straight! I'm always loyal. Meanwhile, at Warm Heart's neighborhood kitchen, 6 days before Mardi Gras.
Welding, most likely. 3 month apprenticeship to start, then the union lets you in.
Yay.
Sammy and Ellis?
Not yet. Gonna wait a few days. Didn't want to spring it on them since I just got back.
Well, they won't like the head, but they'll come around. You need to do what's best for you. Go ahead and start serving those folks. I'll be back.
All right. I shall serve them this. Get out of the way. I shall serve them the soup. Serve them the soup.
Yes, sir.
Enjoy your soup, which instantly forms into a big solid like that. I wonder what kind of soup that is. Oh, it's gumbo. Is gumbo a real thing? Not a clue. Anyway, here you go, Afro Man. Enjoy your gumbo.
Thanks.
Enjoy the rat semen that's in it. Hello, who's next? Hi there. I just wanted an awkward silence between me and this customer. Here you go. I will use my man muscles to pour you some gumbo. Listen, my man. Hello. What can I get for you, sir? Gumbo? Ah, we got plenty of gumbo. Don't worry about it. Here we go. Gumbo for you, sir. And finally, madam, what can I do for you? I can suggest the gumbo, and the gumbo. We also have a gluten-free gumbo, if you'd like. I'm just going to assume you want gumbo. Here you go.
It's a fucking shit show.
I'll see what I can do about that.
I want some gumbo. Give me some gumbo.
How are you, Regine?
Regine?
Nice to see you around the hollow again.
Nice to see those big brown.
Quite a gothic outfit you've got on there.
Well, they'll be over at my aunt's place.
But doesn't look good in that window.
Maybe I'll do that.
Lincoln, we got trouble.
We do? Don't worry, I'm protected by the soup. Soup power! And over I go. Power on the kisser. Oh. Hey, asshole. How dare you come to my soup kitchen? You spoiled my gumbo! Chokeslam, bitch! Ow. Hey! How dare you? You bring a gun to a chokeslam fight? Bastard. Give me the gun. Time to loot the bodies. Hey, what the? A build your own chicken set. I didn't know they still made these. My god, this guy must be a collector.
Papa Doc Duvalier. Was elected president of Haiti in 1957. By 1959, he had created a secret police called Tonton Macoute, and people started to flee. Most of them settled in the southern United States. Now, mixed in with the good, hard-working people were hardened criminals. They formed the backbone of what became the Haitian gang. Now, Lincoln found out they set up in the swamps and were led by a man named Baka.
Which is Japanese for idiot, I do believe.
You and Father James done already?
Yep.
Jump by the Haitians.
I want to build a chicken.
Tell me what's really going on.
Yes. I suppose it is.
Tell me, old man.
6 or 7 months ago, folks in the hollow started getting robbed. Money, jewelry, things of that nature. Didn't take long for us to figure out it was the Haitians.
Okay.
Those
bastard Haitians.
Going after the lottery.
How much money are we talking about? How much?
Go on.
Enough that we're in deep shit with Sal Marcano. Haven't kicked up to him in 3 months.
Jesus Christ. If I deal with them, that gives us time to settle up with Marcano, right?
Oh boy.
Let me worry about Sal. He and I go way back. But this thing with the Haitians. Time for it to end.
Send in the one-man army. Lincoln Clay. I like how I said that and he looked at his brother.
How we gonna find him?
Back in the 20s, folks used to pull salt out of the bayou. They even built themselves a little shanty town. When the depression hit, they abandoned it. That's the only place this could have come from.
Gonna need guns and ammo.
No, we don't.
Call this number. Do it away from here.
No sense tipping anybody off.
Or we could sweep the hollow, track down and kill every last one of those cocksuckers, then we wouldn't have to worry about it.
The last thing folks in this neighborhood need to see is colored people killing each other. Do this quiet. Away from here.
Damn straight.
Eliminate whoever's running the show. The rest of them will go down on their own. Trust me.
I'm a soldier. I know what that means.
Soldier boy, I'll follow your lead.
Be careful, yeah? Those Haitians are hard people. Do not ever underestimate them.
I won't.
C'est lié que c'est divers et c'est suscite hostilité.
I have no idea what it is you just said. Navi did the subtitles. To a degree. My game just crashed. What the fuck? Alright, try this again. Alright, back in the game.
You show this is how you
wanna
play.
I wanna drive. The first time I'm having someone else drive me and it's a cool vehicle, I wanna drive a hovercraft. Or whatever you call these.
I'll meet you over there when this is done.
Hope you know what you're doing.
Trust me, Ellis. Here in a bit, this will all be behind us.
I wonder if Keith David's in this game. Alright. Ellis, if I don't make it, I just want you to know. You're an asshole. Whee! Alright, here we go. Alright, I'm about to show you a pro tip for this game. So, I discovered this by accident last night, and when I did find out it was an achievement, it scared the shit out of me because there was a big noise that came with it as well. Okay, so first, after you get out of the water, you sneak over here. Yeah. When you're stuck, hang on. Get too close, I'll make noise, and the enemy's awareness and the gate will expand. They'll come looking for you. When you're stalking, you'll make less noise and stay out of enemy's line of sight. Okay. But, blah, 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 blah. Okay. So anyway, you go over to this motherfucker over here. And you walk up to him and you go, "Surprise, bitch!" And you get his gun and everything, but then what you do is you get to the point where you can pick up his body, like that. You walk over to the edge like this, and you drop it. Now, this last time I missed it, this time I'm going to try and properly see it. Just wait here a few seconds. Enjoy your snack, Mr. Crocodile! Now, I've already got that achievement, so it doesn't come up, but it is an achievement to feed a body to the sharks. So there you go. When you play it yourselves, you know what to do. Okay, so first off, I'm going to sneak over here. Let the fat guy walk past. Let the fat men walk past. Knock out this guy. And press up against here. Sneak along the other side of the boat. Whoa. Oh, good. I think I can move at full speed and he won't hear me. Right, I'm going to take you down and I'm going to nick your shotgun. You only had 3 bullets for that thing. Stingy bastard. Alright, which way was it I go again? Can I open this? No. I can tell by the way he just face planted it. Right, up. Sneaky. Alright, there is another thing I'm going to mention about this game right now that is frustrating to me. Ooh, what's this? Ooh, carbine. There, that was it. Picked up a carbine last time. So here we go. There's 2 guys right there. I can see them from here. However, they're not targeted. I mean, marked on the map. Surely, I should just be able to look at them like that. And then on the map, they turn up. You know? It just seems like a smart thing to do, doesn't it? Sadly, however, that's not the case. Okay, so now I'm going to show you the mechanic of whistling. So first, I wait for them to finish their conversation. Boring as it is. Then, when one of them walks away, I whistle and attract only one of them because apparently the other one is death. So then, as he gets close, he's carrying a sharp stick as well. That makes him dangerous. But I was in Vietnam. I'm more dangerous, bitch! And down he goes. I want your sharp stick, but no, I can't use sharp sticks. Melee items aren't a thing in this game. Okay, right, I'm just going to check this room quickly. Just make sure there's no collectibles. I probably missed a bunch of collectibles anyway. Okay, so... Oh, look, beating up car. No. No. Some enemies over there. My enemies over there. Ooh, there's a guy right here. Okay, I actually went this way last time, so what I'm going to do... is I'm going to... Ooh! Well, if you want to call that a stealth takedown, I'm fine with it, but... Part of me thinks that was a bit loud and maybe a bit uncalled for. But anyway, so let's see. All right. Now, I think I can leave those bodies there because they won't patrol that far. I'm going to move over here just a bit. Yep, nothing that way. So I'm going to sneak up across here. Oh, wow. That was a hell of a jump, Lincoln. Right, can't jump up there. Right, so I'm just going to scout a bit here. So what have we got? I've got 3 guys, I do believe. Yeah, 1 at the back, 1 patrolling, 1 here. Okay, so... If I sneak down here, now the first thing I'll have to do is probably take out the guy who's either patrolling or take out this guy here. Because once he goes down, he'll be hidden by the fence. And then take him out last. Tactics, as brought to you by Zach. Now, just wait for the fat bastard to turn around. Swap cover just in case. There he is. Okay. Right, he stopped at the fire. That works for me, because then I can just take him down like that. And then go jump over. Take him down again. Wait, I say take him down again. Take him down for the first time. Right, just to be safe as well. I'm going to move this body just to be safe. Right, I'm going to move him into the shadows, where nobody will ever find him. Well, good thing there's no enemy in that one. Alright, I'm actually going to sneak in this way, just to avoid the light. Okay, here we go. Med kit? No, I haven't taken a hit. I'm perfectly fine. Where is my health? Unless it's doing that whole red screen thing that makes it harder for you to take cover the more you get shot. Stupid mechanic, really, but there we go. Okay, there we go. I hear a conversation going. Right, from now on, I am blind because at this point, because I don't know what's coming up, I don't know what's going to happen, I don't know who's going to say what. This is as far as I got before I turned it off last night when I was testing it out. So, I'm going to sneak in here, and I'm going to stay low. Now, do I check the house? Oh, hang on, there's a guy patrolling. Which way are you going? Please come this way, please come this way. No, you'll go that way, that works for me. So that's him down. Oh boy. Take him down because he's just out of the line of sight of the other guy. Being a bit hasty there, I need to be more careful. And sneak up across here. I'm going to try actually... Yeah, I'm going to see what happens if I can do a gun execution. Ooh! Fucking hell, I heard it ring! Oh, that... Oh! That made me cringe then. All right. Wow, this guy can take a beating. Oh, yeah? Well, first I'll take care of your guys first. Ooh, bloody hell. Did you see the blood fly out of his head? Who's next? Step right up. Step right up. Who's ready to die? Right, time to execute you. How do I do it? Carbine or pistol? Carbine. Why the fuck not? All right, let's do this. Oh, no, it's a cutscene. Never mind. You're a big fella as well, ain't you? Oh, what a miss.
The man you're talking about took me in when I had nowhere else to go. You
are no better than you. Kill him. He's insulting you. Kill him. Oh, was that it? Just breaking the neck? I thought you was going to throw him into something else. Oh, no. Oh, no. You okay, lady?
You can't take those shoes! You fucking pig! Damn you to her!
Oh, Cassandra. She's advertised as one of the main characters, I think.
Take it easy! He kept me in there. Locked in there. Day and night. Beat me. Use me. I kiss you, motherfucker! You and your entire goddamn family!
He's dead! He's dead! He can't hurt you anymore.
Joe, but you should let him, let her at least whack him. Let her vent her frustration. She's probably been waiting for that. Go, get out of here, quick! Do you need an escort? She may need an escort. Ooh! I saw a Molotov symbol! What's that noise? Ah, motherfucker! Molotovs and grenades. Hold right bumper, throw and release, cancel. Select explosives by... Wait, what? I've got to select them in the weapons wheel and throw them with that. Are you sure that's right? Hold on. Right, where am I looking? Oh, there we go. Oh, right. My bad. Oh, I see what it means. Right, you use right bumper at the bottom there. Makes sense. Right, I need a gun. Wait, it's a machine gun? I thought it was a carbine. Oh well, never mind. I have the high ground, motherfuckers! You can't win! I can't see anybody, though. Quite hard to see. These machine guns are inaccurate as fuck. Alright, who's next? Anyone? Who's next? You're close. You'll die. Next. And... you good, sir! Back there in the corner. How would you like to die next? That might be a yes, but he's moving. Hold on. Hold on. Now he's dead. I think there's one more. Hello? I know you're there. Maybe I should try and lure him out. Whoosh! I'm going to see if I can scrounge some ammo from the bodies. Sneaking, I am sneaking. Sneaking, I am sneaking. Sneaking, sneaking. Ooh, a Molotov. I'll take a Molotov, why not? Pistol, pistol. Ooh, Tommy gun. Someone saw me, whoever it was. Where? Oh, he's up there. Yeah, I can shoot better than you, bitch. Was that his head or the wood? Well, he's dead now, either way. Right, this is almost out. I'm gonna grab me a Tommy gun. Which is also almost out. Fuck. Right, gotta keep going. Gotta keep moving, keep on running, keep on hiding, and all the other song references I'm gonna make during this video. And boosh! Oh, found some more ammo. Nice. Where am I looking? Where do I need to go? That way. Let's try and be stealthy about this one. It's not happening. Already gave myself away because I couldn't see him. Bam! 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 Ooh! Some of those look pretty harsh. And painful. Anyway, I'm going to try and sneak around the back here. There is a fence there. I'm not sneaking around that back, but I can climb in the window. Hee hee. The perfect crime. I'm blocked by chairs. I vault over the chairs. Are they still looking for me? Do they know I'm here? Can they keep sneaking? Can I keep sneaking around? Careful. Bullshit. He only... Haha! Something. Oh god, oh god. Oh, what? What was the symbol about? Fuck you, seriously. Alright, here we go. Where's he at? Whoa, do a pirouette! Oh god, that looked like it hurt, whatever it was. Stay low. Oh, did I get him? I think I got him. I'm good. Don't worry about me. Okay. Right. Oh, God. Missed every shot. Bye. Oh, you've sustained critical injuries. Your health is low. Take cover until your health restored or use an adrenaline shot. Press up for an adrenaline shot. I don't have any. and safe. I can take critical shots and just walk them off, because I'm Lincoln Clay. I'm a tough guy. Throwing a Molotov, I didn't see where it went. Which way? Speaking of which, I have my own Molotov. Here you go, enjoy! I missed. I'm liking this game so far, uh-oh. Oh god, I nearly Molotov my own car. Fucking hell. Excuse me, quick. Ah, you nearly hit me, you stupid bastard. Let me in. Oh. Why do I have to drive? Fuck's sake. Alright, let's go.
Always gotta get you out of trouble, don't I?
Shut up.
Came to an understanding.
Oh, did we?
Stay dead, not let him. Let's get back to Sammy's.
Can't even tell you how happy Pops is gonna be.
He probably won't be.
The Haitians has been weighing on him.
They're probably about to attack our house because they know where we are, and we've killed the leader. Ow! We've just killed the leader. They're probably gonna come for a revenge hit on the very same night.
For months, we needed to do something like this, but Pops, he—I don't know. Sometimes I think he's lost the taste for this shit.
Just because a man don't rush to violence don't mean he lost something.
I know, just makes me wonder what happens after, you know?
No, I don't know. Explain it to me.
Don't matter if it's a bullet or the hand of God. We all go sometime, right?
Yep.
I suppose. But Ellis, we don't need to talk about it.
I pray that Pops outlives the both of us. But if he doesn't, every motherfucker...
Ow! Okay, right, I think I might take it back and the cars are a little bit slidey.
Every motherfucker in the hollow's gonna be looking to us or gunning for us. Just saying we gotta be ready when that day comes.
Oh, we will be, don't you fucking worry, Mike.
Worry about right now. So just cool it with your grand plans, alright?
Yeah, alright.
It's hard to see right now. Might be a good idea to just not drive really fast. Okay, I'm just taking it slow. Don't mind me. I didn't just kill a swamp full of people. Don't mind me. Just heading home. Went to go watch a film. What's a film from the 1960s? That's Dracula. Yeah. I think we're safe. Over the bridge and far away. And time for a drift. Okay. Oh. That was close. I nearly scratched the car. Sorry! I can't see. The sun's in my eyes. Oh, God. That was like a ghost. Right, here I... Oh, God. Definitely not a good idea to stay there. Right, I'm bringing the car back. And safe. No one will ever know a thing, except predictable storylines. We'll say that somebody did know.
Or maybe want to understand. Is that for a man like Sammy? There's always gonna be more Haitians. Now, if there wasn't someone
told you, didn't I?
Sammy, then there was someone else forcing him into a bad situation. It was never going in. That's how man can end up working for Sal Marcano.
You were right about those Haitians being down by that old salt mine. They won't be bothering us again.
Oh yeah, they will.
Stick sending you down there. I should handle my own business.
This isn't any different than what I was doing before I left.
It's true. Or is it?
You probably don't know this. But every night on the TV, right after the news, they show the names of all the boys killed over there in Vietnam. I'd be sitting in the kitchen eating my supper. Watching that list scroll by, wondering if today is the day I finally see your name.
That must be devastating if you see that, though.
Nothing happened to me.
There's only so much luck down the well. Sooner or later, pull up that bucket, there's nothing in it.
So,
metaphors out the arse, yo.
Pay him his goddamn money one way or the other.
Lottery gonna be enough to cover it?
The lottery? No. But Sal called a bit ago. Wants you to meet him up the country club. Says he's got something in the works.
Oh, does he?
Square things up between us.
The only black folk allowed in there to help.
Now, they may not like it, but they're not gonna say no to Sal Marcano. He says you get to come in, you get to come in.
He sounds like a hell of a guy.
I always did want to see the inside of that place.
I'm going to go for a drive intoxicated again.
For all our sakes.
Yes, sir.
And I'm off. See ya. Flash of the glass there. Alright, well. Is that it? Is that the end of the prologue or not? Let me just check. Let's have a look. What have we got here? Map. Look how big this map is, though. I can't believe that it's just going to be me driving from mission to mission. There's got to be more. I mean, look, up there, a kill list. I don't know what feature that is. And I want to know what that is. Right. Is that the end of the epilogue? I don't think so. But this video's gone on for long enough already. So, everyone watching at home, thank you for tuning in and watching me play Mafia 3. This is going to be a full playthrough, so expect more soon. Impressions of the game so far? It's definitely intriguing. I do want to see where the story goes. The mechanics are pretty tight. You know, the shooting does have a bit of a flaw, as you saw with the machine gun at the start, when I wasn't able to hit anybody with it at all. But I think the game's going to get better as we go along. So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for tuning in and watching Mafia 3. If you like it, there's four ways to let us know. Liking, commenting, subscribing, and sharing, because each one really helps out and keeps content coming to you. Thanks for dropping by, everyone, and I'll see you next time. Yeah.